for each one. You can vote for, like, if you want the council to just have 2 years, but you want the administrator to have four, I think you should be able to pick that, you know? Someone say, you know what, we need a leader here for 4 years, but the council, maybe we don't. And the other thing is, you may get a good candidate that can do 2 years, but may not be able to do four. If it's a four-year commitment, you sit there and say, wow, 4 years is a long time. 2 years, you can do it, like I said, for me, that if it said four, I would never have run, because you don't know. And, you know, and you could get burnt out after two, and then you're useless, you're staying on, and you're not really fresh, like Mr. Bierkant says too. I don't think you're as fresh. If you want to do it again, it's because you want to, and you get elected. And if you don't, 4 years is a long time. So I'd say do it individual. If you want to have, like, I would think maybe an administrator to stay for. I might, if it was me voting, I would vote for that, for four for administrator, but I wouldn't vote for four for a town council, because I know how it is, and I'd be like, you know, you might lose some guys that you could have for 2 years that would be very good at it. And if they want to run again, they could. So I like splitting them up just the way they have it, yeah.
If I may, if it remains 2 years for council members and goes for 4 years to administrator. Now, currently we're blessed with a great administrator. We haven't always had this. And new people coming in will be deferring to the administrator for input, one-on-one input, or maybe within a town council meeting. I just think it's dangerous we wouldn't have to worry about it with Mr. Azowski. I'll say that in the public. But there's been concern in the past. If that had been the case in the past, we would have had some serious concern. Then there would have been motion to get 30% of the electorate to go out and do a recall. You know, I just think 2 years is...
But I'm not saying for the administrator. There might be a lot of people that said, hey, I don't want, you know, the administrator to have 4 years. Two, and let's vote him out too, or him or her.
You're saying, you know, put it out there.
Put it out there.
Individual questions.
Individual questions, yes.
Like I suggested.
Yep, but this way, yeah, okay. Let the people decide what they want.
Yeah, good point. Thanks, Tom.
Now, all right, my suggestion, and obviously you disagree, is that this should be broken up into three questions. Okay, town council, seven members, you in favor of seven members or five members? That's one question. You in favor of, where is it?
2 years or 4 years?
2 years or 4 years? That's another question.
There's a third question.
What is it?
Vian Zwolenski. I might have to legally change my name to A. Zwolenski, A. Russo, or something of that. You know, if you list the candidates alphabetically, you have seven to choose from, six.
Oh, shit, I already picked five. I did not call.
That's it.
Also staggered terms if we did the 4 years.
Yeah, I'm not staggered. This is...
If we did that, well, that's if we improve 4 years, we have to go back in.
Yeah.
Right.
I'm definitely for not seven people.
Yeah,
as am I.
I would agree.
You can't even afford five, you know? So, you know, to sit here with seven people, there's times when, you know, three of us will agree and two might not, but can you imagine, like when we've watched other cities and stuff?
Oh my God, no.
It is horrible that everyone has their input. You're there all night.
Yeah.
If you can't get five people to do the job, it's not even worth the seven. If you can't do it with five, don't bother. Because that would be unbelievable. I would no with seven.
So once again then, for that reason then, that would be another reason to break up this question.
Break it up, yeah.
All right, so the questions then would be, the questions then would be presented as, question would be, are you in favor of five members or seven members? That's one question. The other question would be,
2 years.
2 years or 4 years? And that'd be another question. And then the third question, which doesn't exist, the one I was suggesting, but I can go without that. I can pass on that. questions, because we're broken up into two questions. Can we do that?
Yes. I think you could do something like that. I think if you, if seven members is approved and four-year term as presented, this question all works together. Seven, four, and all the staggered terms. If you're gonna break it up, then it's gonna be, you're gonna have seven members with 4 years and staggered terms, or you're gonna have five members, or if you're gonna even consider the other terms.
So if we're looking at doing five members in 2 years, then we're just doing...
And you don't, you don't have a question, you're just questioning, just this question.
And you let, and you let the public decide every 2 years, it's, that's quo.
They're getting it, you don't like it?
Seven's too many, I don't even want them to grow.
I don't want...
They wanna do five. If you...
I'm not even giving them that, what's that?
If you don't, if you potentially wanna consider four-year terms for the council at five, then you can make another question, so you can say this question would be one question. Seven council members, four-year term staggered, just as it is. Yes or no?
Yeah, it does become cumbersome.
After a while, you know what's gonna happen? What'd you vote on? First one came out, I've been working on that.
That's a different question, you know, the bottom line is a lot of changes to the charter, it takes a lot of questions. You're not gonna be able to put them all together, because if you do, you're gonna put people in positions either want yes or no on everything. And, you know, that's a hard thing to do, when you talk about major changes in government.
I'm coming back with a two-year term for five members, I'll get over the alphabetical thing, I don't have a problem with that, I'm just saying. I was kinda joking, but it's true. You win seven, they're gonna go...
So then I can present this, I can make the motion to accept this, and if it goes down, then it stays two-year terms, and it stays...
Just the way it is.
Five.
Five members? Okay.
Five members in 2 years.
Yeah.
So nothing changes, why...
If you vote no on this, nothing changes. If you vote yes on this, this...
It goes to the ballot.
Goes to the ballot.
Yeah, I'd rather not even go to the ballot.
Well, that's why I thought one thing, that's true, but... Oh, Mr. Vannen?
The commission has recommended four-year terms for all elected officials. Regardless of whether you have seven members or five members, it's our recommendation that we have four-year terms for people, which would make staggered terms on the council. And to answer Mr. McGee's comment, you might get some people that would be more interested in a four-year term than a two-year term seeking reelection. To flip your line that you were using that, you might have a good candidate that doesn't want to serve 4 years. You might have some people that don't want to put their name in because it's only 2 years. So it kind of works both ways. But we're recommending four-year terms for all. Whether it's seven or five, we still recommend four-year term staggered with the council. That would be our recommendation. We showed up with seven, but figuring that it could be broken down into numerous questions, seven members, four-year staggered terms, even, you know what I mean? You could vote for five or seven, but it's still 4 years staggered terms, or that could die too. But they could be separate questions.
Yeah, all right, so why don't I do this? I'll break it up into two questions. Okay, the first question is, are you in favor of seven members, seven-member council, or a five-member council? And then the second, and then we'll see what happens after that question. Then after that, I will say, the next question will be, are you in favor of two-year terms or four-year terms? So we'll break that up into two questions, like you said.
Well, then we're giving the voters a chance.
No, you can vote now.
Oh, we can vote right now.
You can vote right now. Okay. I'm not saying we're putting on the ballot that way. I'm saying I present it to you that way.
Yeah.
And then you can vote no or yes.
Yeah, because I totally disagree with Paul.
Yeah. So
we're on two.
So when I ask you if you're in favor of seven or five, I'll just say you're in favor of seven members.
Yeah.
It would be, you would vote no.
Yeah.
Okay. So can you help me word this?
I just want to understand. If you're trying to break, first of all, if you want to consider this proposal in section one, right, as is, in total, seven members, four-year term, staggered term, up or down. And if that goes down, then you could potentially pursue these other options. In other words, is this, if you want to say, do you want seven members first? Is that what you want to do first?
Yeah.
Okay, then just say, do we want to increase the council members to seven members?
Okay. Is there a motion to increase the council members, council to 7 members? Is there a motion? I'll entertain a motion for that. Okay, once again, I will ask if there's entertain a motion to increase the council to 7 members.
So moved.
Is there a second? Okay, dies for lack of second.
So now the next portion of the thing talks about terms of 4 years. If you want to have that decided.
Okay.
And you had talked about the potential options.
I will entertain a motion now to change the terms of the council from 2 years to 4-year terms. Is there a motion to change the length of the council from 2 years to 4 years?
So moved.
Is there a second? Dead.
So I don't think that's it. The language regarding staggered terms matters.
It's irrelevant.
Irrelevant, because right now it states 5 members to a million. Without changing the term before, the staggered portion will not apply.
Correct.
So we'll defer to Mr. Badden, I don't see on the staggered.
So everything remains the same. That's cool.
All right, section 2, qualifications. This was a cleanup to be consistent with the law, from what the way I read it, and because the charter can't supersede federal law or state law. So this is just a cleanup. I'll entertain a motion to approve.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Mrs. Bonneville?
Yes.
Mrs. McGee?
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara?
Yes.
Mr. Zelensky?
Yes.
Mr. Biragad?
Yes.
Mr. President, I would just point out, just so it's clear, it does do that. It just adds one more tooth that goes beyond the Ethics Commission. The Ethics Commission law in Rhode Island is you can never serve in a position 1 year after you leave this body. If it's appointed by this body, this is saying you can never serve in any position with the town 1 year after you leave this body, regardless of whether it's appointed by this body. In other words, Mr. Ivoski could not, right now under ethics rules, Mr. Bosky could appoint one of you within 1 year. But this is not going to let that happen. That's just gives it one more tooth.
Okay.
Oh, I thought that's the way it always was.
No. No, it's always by the body. That's what, but I just wanted to make clear. So it is cleaning up the law, you're right, to be consistent. But it's just giving a little bit more meat, a little bit more protection. One more year of prohibition.
Okay,
so to carry that further, let's make a scenario, and I'm going to let my distinguished colleague to my right here. If Mrs. O'Hara wanted to be, I'm making this up, of course, an advocate for senior citizens, empathy, well-qualified to be someone to run that.
Yeah.
So within a year's time, should a position become available and the town administrator wishes to appoint that person with the approval of town council, that would remove some of that problem, would it not?
No, this is covering that. This is, that can't happen.
Right, but I'm trying to say, would it be allowed with the approval of town council? So if someone was very highly qualified.
The approval, no.
Huh?
No, the approval, I know it's not appointment, but the approval, the Ethics Commission said, you know, can't have any approval process by the body in which you come from.
Okay, got it. Thanks.
So the moment you're going to be approved by the body.
Well, then, after 1 year. Mr. Borga, I want to be a public safety commissioner. Highly qualified. We'd have to wait 1 year.
Right.
These are all hypotheticals. Mm-hmm. Highly 1 year. Okay.
Even if it's a non-paying
Non-paying. This is only paid.
Okay. Any
one
type of advocacy for children, that still is endorsed.
This is about money.
I can be on the guide and qualified.
Okay. So does anybody know where the air conditioning control panel is?
They have to have air conditioning,
They have to at least stand in the
air. You can't breathe.
No, it's all right. It's all right. I worked in a hut all day. This is nothing.
Yeah, but I'm
going to talk. Do you know how to run it,
Joe? Okay. Well, you built this building. You know where it is? Well,
is it accessible, or do you have to take the cartridge out of your menu?
I think there's a lock on it.
It's a lock.
Keep the kitchen
door. But sometimes you can get that. The old units used to be able to take a pen refill.
We need to get something.
But a hairdryer on it.
Guys, that would make it up, if I want to take it in, right?
It's my kitchen show.
Me too.
Okay, I solved the initial problem, if somebody wished to come, Kyle, you're a tech, you're a techie.
Oh.
You're a lefty.
No, I'm on, you need a code.
I know, well, it's what I do, I'm on, so.
Oh, you need a code.
I remember they used to lock the heat up, going to that energy thing, they put it down to 66.
Oh, is that business judging?
Then the kids, the nose would get red, everybody had red nose, so we knew them.
Unless we go way off.
Yeah.
Even they way off.
Well, they way off, yeah.
Yeah.
You should have made a bet, like, if every 15 minutes is a bet.
Is it first?
I've done that, it doesn't work for me.
Okay.
It's where I was, hey, it's not your fault.
So for those folks that maybe served for more than two terms, they could remember that the control is in their computers.
So it's done?
We move, whether it works or not, Kyle.
All right, so moving on, page 15, section 6, we're gonna, we can disregard, because that only is in effect if there are, if we go to 7 minutes, right?
But pursuant to Rhode Island Open Meetings Act.
So there's no motion made on number six?
No motion made.
Yep.
And it remains.
Right?
Yeah.
That's satisfying, clerk, Madam Clerk?
Yes, it is.
No motion made.
If you go to section 7, all right, it discusses the meetings being twice a month. The town council shall meet regularly, no less frequently than twice each month. So every July, then we would be in violation of the charter.
That's right.
Right.
Well, we've had, we're gonna have three meetings in July.
We're gonna have three meetings right now.
That's a good point, but that's not always gonna be the case.
So not less frequently than once each month, covers it.
We don't have a meeting this week in July.
Leave it alone.
Oh, okay.
So just leave it.
We have to make a motion to leave it then.
Yeah, so.
You don't have to make a motion to leave it, you just need to ask if there's any motion to move it.
Okay.
Existing language either stays or gets changed. Is there a motion to change?
Is there a motion to, is there a motion to accept the changes made, suggested by the charter commission? A motion?
So moved, yeah.
Is there a second? Dies for lack of second. Go to page 16.
The bottom, President.
Not getting ahead of myself.
Pursuant to the Rhode Island Open.
Oh, okay.
Mr. President, this was intended to make the charter consistent with state law, which is controlling anyway. Probably at the time of the charter was not in its present form.
Okay, motion to approve that change on pursuant to Rhode Island Open Meetings Act.
So moved.
Second.
Second, roll call.
Bye, Molly.
Yes.
McGee.
Yes.
O'Hara.
Yes.
Mr. Miller.
Yes.
Yerbach.
Yes. Page 16, number 7, it was just looked at, just a cleanup, changing the compensation of salaries and benefits. Is the motion to approve?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Roll call.
Mrs. Bottomoli.
Yes.
Mr. McGee.
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara.
Yes.
Mrs. Moore.
Yes.
Mr. Yerbach.
Yes. Page 17, section 23, the change is the council alone shall have the authority to ratify all contracts and collective bargaining. It's just reaffirming the rules of the council.
Motion to accept, Mr. President.
Second.
Roll call.
Mrs. Bottomoli.
Yes.
Mr. McGee.
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara.
Yes.
Mrs. Moore.
Yes.
Mr. Yerbach.
Yes. Number 24 is irrelevant now, but there will be no motion taken because we did not go to 7 members. Page 18, once again, the affirmative vote of 3-4, that only changes if we went to 7.
Actually, Mr. President, we recommend that that stay there, whether you have 4 members or whether you have 7 or 5 members, we recommend that four councilmen do for passage of an ordinance, not just simple majority.
Okay.
Okay, let me go back there real quick, I'm sorry.
So you're looking for a super, that's saying that we require a super majority.